So to my surprise, there's actually another video on top of this video, because when I recorded the first part of the video, I actually found out there was some more somewhere else on the official fan clubs. So stick around for after the exhibition PV as well. Hope you enjoy. Kubo the Mad Lad smacks a PV, which I wasn't expecting until the exhibition. I can never say exposition. Exhibition. There you go. I can say the word now. Yeah, I saw this. I don't know how long it is. It could be 30 seconds, but I want to live react to it just in case it's a banger. Because you never know. There might be something at the end. But the tweet says anyway, Bleach information on the first original exhibition. Bleach X has been lifted. Experience 20 years of progress with your soul. A PV that you can't take your eyes off for a moment. My heart is shaken. In the future, exhibition information will be posted on YouTube. So subscribe to the channel. So there's a new channel. Okay. Let's have a look. Which is good. Okay. Bleach X. Hit that sub. Hit that like. And this is 48 minutes. Okay. Let's jump into this. Okay. Looks good. Yeah. Oh, nice, nice. Okay. They look like volume covers. Nice. Now, okay. Baruka, soon, maybe. Yoruichi Kisuke, the Fear Rukia. Oh, that's so cool. Yeah. Oh, this, they've put a lot of work into this. Yeah, okay. Vibey. Did they go the Deer Seed? You watch the Almighty. There you go. That's cool. Dope. Yeah. Oh, okay. That was it. To just relay that right quick, it seems like, and I'll just be replaying it as the video comes through because I'm not screen sharing, but it seems like, you know, we got some touch-ups, we got some extra, because I know some of these were panel shots, so some of some lines have been added. I did initially think that these were volume covers at first, but no, that isn't the case. But whoever animated this is absolutely beautiful. French kiss. Beautiful. And yeah, this was a nice little touch up on to go on to. Is there a theme with this? No, not really. It just shows Bankais. It just shows each character and their names with the styles of text, which is cool. And then, of course, they showed a little bit of Turn Back the Pendulum, which was really cool. Eyes in at the back. Yeah, Kubo worked on this. He chose the music. And yeah, like, this is pretty cool. This is, I'm really feeling... Yeah, beautiful. I loved it. It's good to see these panels in really good high definition quality. Yeah, this week is really feeling really Bleach-esque. And if this is, they're going to be posting stuff on this YouTube channel. That's pretty cool. And honestly, yeah, I wasn't expecting this until December, if I'm honest with you. So there you go. There's your PV that I said you would be getting. I'm surprised it came as soon as it did. Yeah, go subscribe to the channel. Go show some love for it. Hopefully this will get you excited. Go read the chapter. The chapter is out now. And we're going to go view it. We're going to go talk about it. We're going to deep dive into it. I've done a lot of notes. So hopefully it's a really insightful video. So there's not really much to say here. Since as this is an exclusive like 30 minute video. Showing the process of like Kubo drawing this page here at Zyla Programs. I will say I am so glad. I'm so glad. And I, you know, people... for some reason thought that the majority of the chapter was digital. No, this is still very much his hand written drawings. It's the same with Burn the Witch. He really does his colors. He likes to experiment with his colors and color pages within the digital art form that he's been trying out as of recently. But when it comes to the black and white pages, it seems that he is sticking to the traditional style of drawing, which is fantastic, because I do think that's his flair, that's his own style, and it works. And why would you want to change something that works? So it's good to see him really work hard on a chapter again. It is kind of in a way surreal to see how his studio is looking right now. It is different. It seems like he's in a different environment. I was hoping to see his editors within this video. He still has editors clearly, because towards the end of the video you'll see like he makes some notes, some like editor notes, such as like a cross where he wants his blacks, etc. And within the chapter review as well, I will bring up something quite important, and that's a hole right in Xyloporos is like chest, which is interesting because I don't think I gotta double check, but I don't think that is there before, and I feel like that might be an important character design trait to focus on what that is, because it doesn't, if it was a part of the chain, each hole would be in each like chain lock, which isn't the case. So again, it is so nice to see just Kubo like really dabbling in, seeing his setup, seeing his workflow, and just seeing him draw. And not see, I remember I was seeing Kubo draw from like back in the Thousand Year Blood War, the second half of the Thousand Year Blood War, and it was like a really low quality footage that was shared, and you could see like his left hand was all all shaking, and that was due to the torn ligament within his shoulder. So it's good to finally watch him really calmly draw. And yeah, it just looks, I'm just really glad that it is hand drawn and not digital, because again, like, it's very nostalgic, if that makes sense. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed looking at this. Obviously this is a 30 minute video, so I'm not going to show the whole thing. So from what I show, it's literally just this for the majority of the part. So yeah, I am going to catch you guys soon for the review. You guys of course have this fine day, Hanson, as always, people. Peace out.